Hello everyone, myself Bhumi Patel, Assistant Professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Instrumentation and Control. Today's our topic is PLC Networking in the unit number 16, PLC Networking. So whenever we deal with the PLC, we are using a different types of networking that is used in the PLC programming as well as the PLC hardware. So first of all, there are different levels of the industrial control that is used for the PLC networking. So in general, we have used total 5 levels of the industrial control. So first of all, we talk about the level number 5. The level number 5 is known as the enterprise control levels, and in this level they contain the sales control and the cost control. Okay, now the next level is the level number 4. Okay, so the level number 4 is known as the total factory control, and in the total factory control they contain the production control, scheduling and the inventory control. Now the next level is level number 3. In the level number 3, the level number 3 is known as the group controls. The group control is subdivided into the work cell. Now the next level is level number 2. The level number 2 is known as the individual control, and in the individual control there are 3 sub partition is there: single purpose, multi-purpose and the programmable. And the last level is level number 1. It is the manual control that contains the machine, devices and different types of components. Okay, now whenever we deal with the different type of industrial control that is used in the PLC networking, so the main thing or the best thing is that we have always start with the lower level and reach to the upper level. Okay, we cannot control the programming from the upper level to the lower level. So here in the industrial control, they contain total 5 levels. So first of all, we have to control the level number 1, then level number 2, 3, 4, 5 and continue. Okay, we cannot control the level from the top level to the bottom level. So first of all, we will study about the level number 1. Okay, now what is the actual meaning of the level number 1? So level 1 is known as the manual control. Now what is the manual control? So they are subdivided the manual control in the 3 parts: machine, device and component. Okay, in some company or a specified company is work on a specific task. Suppose we have deal with the lathe machine, so our company will be work only the lathe machine. Okay, or if we have to build a cutting machine, so my company will be work only the cutting purpose. Okay, so which type of machine that we have to deal with this company, or which type of devices, or we have take the example like PCB manufacturing company. So they will build a PCB for the specific company requirement. Okay, so level number 1, they will work only the one task. Okay, during the process or during the time, they will done only the one task. If they will making the PCB for this particular software company, so every time or every day they will work only the PCB manufacture. The other work is not there. Okay, so level 1 is the basic level of the industrial control. Okay, in the industrial control we deal with the only hardware component of this plant, or we will work the repeated work for this particular system. Understood? Now the upper level is level number 2. Okay, the level number 2 is known as the individual control. Now, what is the individual control? We will control the device individually for the single purpose, multi-purpose or the programmable. So, you have to say that in the individual control, we will work the hardware as well as the PLC software. Okay, if my company will be work only one manufacturer or only one devices, that time my company control is known as the single purpose control level. If my company will be work more than one work, suppose we are manufacture the PCB as well as we will manufacture the different types of components that are mounted on the PCB, like resistor, capacitor, inductor. So it is known as the multi-purpose control level. Okay, and for that if programming is required, because ultimate the company will be work the same thing. Okay, it will be single purpose or the multi-purpose, but the ultimate output is the same for the all day. So if the programming is required for this particular system, so we will enter the PLC software for this particular level if required. So depending upon the company requirement and the customer requirement, we will divide the level number 2 into the 3 types: single purpose, multi-purpose, programmable. Every small industry or every small company will be work level number 1 and level number 2. Okay, clear? So this is all about the level number 2. Now in the level number 3, group control. And the sub part of the group control is work cell. Okay, now what is the basic purpose of the group control? Okay, now you have a big company. The company will be work more than one work. Okay, they will build or the manufacture the PLC. Also, they will build a resistor, different types of capacitor, different range of inductor. Okay, now we have to collect all the components and then we have to design a one PCB for some other requirement. Okay, so for that we have to divide the company employee for this particular group. The first group will be work on the PCB, the second group will be work on the power supply, or the third group will be work on the different type of component, electrical or the electronic component. So when more than one task is there, we will divide the work into number of group. Now the individual group will be work individually, and after that whatever work is there, we will collect this work and then we have to combine this circuit and then we have to run this PCB and check that proper output is there or not. Suppose TV manufacturing company is there and we have to make a PCB for the TV. Okay, so for that we have to divide the group for the PCB, power supply or different type of component that is used for the TV manufacturing, and then we have to combine these all three things and then we have to connect this PCB to this TV and then we have to check that it will be work properly or not. So in the level number 3, if my company will be work more than 2 or 3 works, then we have to divide this work into the group and then we have to combine these all the work. Okay, so 50% of the company will be work on the level number 3. Now what is the level number 4? Level number 4 is the total factory control, and in this they will contain the production control, scheduling and the inventory control. Okay, now the next two level number 4 and 5 is all about the production and ultimating the cost of this particular product. Okay, if we are manufacturing the PCB for this particular company and the requirement of the PCB is more than the production, that time we have to decide or we have to generate the more employee for this particular one. Okay, so using the level number 3, we have to identify that how many items is required for this particular year. So we have to prepare the scheduling for this particular production, and then we have to work for this particular level. And level number 5 is known as the enterprise control. It controls the sales and cost. Okay, my company is PCB manufacturing. Okay, if we have to make 1000 PCB for this particular year 2021, okay, now the sales of this particular year is not more than 500. So now what we can do in the next year 22-23, we have to reduce the production for this particular PCB manufacturing. Meanwhile, my company will be work on the other products, suppose the lathe machine, and the requirement of the lathe machine is more than the production. That time we have to increase the production of the lathe machine. So depending upon the sales, we have to decide that how many product that we have to manufacture in the next year, or how many reduce the production of this next year. As well as cost is also important. If my working my company will be work on the same PCB manufacturing, this same PCB manufacturing will be work on the other company, they will, the cost of the other company is less than to our company. So we have to also ultimate or costimate the cost of this particular product, otherwise our sales will be down. Okay, so level number 5 is generally operate as the manager level. They will always take care about the sales of the product and the ultimate cost that of this particular product for this particular marketing survey. Okay, so level of the industry control are generally used in the all these company. If my company will be small, they will work only level number 1 and 2 or 3, and if my production is large, at that time we will go through the level number 5. Clear? Okay, now next is different types of networking that is used in the PLC. So plant controller will be divided into the area controller, and the area controller will be divided into the different types of cell controller, and again the cell controller will be divided into sub type of the controller. So there are different types of networking that is used in the PLC networking. Okay, so as we discussed earlier, always start with the bottom layer of this networking and end with the higher level of the networking. Now what is the plant controller? So the types of networking is also known as the SIM, computer integrated manufacturing. In the exam they will also ask that explain the SIM. That time you have to write the different types of networking. So here we are distributed of processing tasks in the plant according to their function. Okay, so the first is the cell controller. It is generally responsible for the data visualization and the direct machine control. Okay, so it is generally work on the level number 1 and 2, that is always deal with the data collection and direct machine control. The next is the area control. So they are assigned the task of machine and the tool management, maintenance tracking, machine handling, and the tracking, computer assistant simulation, and design facility. So in the area controller, we will work on the hardware as well as different types of software that is used for the different types of networking. And this is the higher level of the controller that is used in the networking. It is known as the plant controller. it is generally responsible for such things as purchasing, accounting, material management, resource planning and report generation. So as we compare the industrial control and types of networking, so in the cell control they will convert the level number 1 and 2, level number 3 will be in the area control, and level number 4 and 5 is in the plant controller, because in the plant controller they will always responsible for the purchasing, accounting, material management or the report generation. Clear? Thank you everyone. If anyone have doubt regarding this topic, you have to contact me in my email ID.